You know, this is quite good, but it would taste better with some quack amole. What are the weirdest species that can and do mate? A species is a group of organisms that share genetic heritage. They are able to interbreed and to create offspring that are also fertile. If you take two subspecies within the same species, you can get fertile offspring. Take the Czechoslovakian wolf dog for example. It's a mix of wolves and dogs. And it is fertile because dogs and wolves are part of the same species, which is Canis lupus. Another example is the killer bee. It was created as an attempt to make a tamer and more manageable bee by mixing two subspecies of honeybees. Spoiler alert, it didn't work. Otherwise, we would call it the friendly bee or something. Anyway, this experiment was a disaster, and now we have killer bees. There are a lot of different species that can interbreed, often giving viable but sterile offspring. Some cool examples are the peasley, a hybrid between the grizzly and the polar bear, the zonkey, a mix of zebra and donkey, the geep, goat plus sheep, the llama, a hybrid between the camel and the llama, the liger, lion and tiger, or the leopard, leopard and lion. There are many others, but I think those are among the coolest. What are the consequences of a colony collapse disorder in bees? Aren't bees the cutest? A colony collapse disorder, or CCD, is when the majority of worker bees in a colony disappear, leaving the queen in the hive with immature bees. The causes of these syndromes are not very well understood. Pesticides, pathogens, genetic factors, poor nutrition, but also environmental factors such as climate change are possible causes. But none of those factors stand out compared to the others, the problems probably being multifactorial. Still today, experts are trying to understand what is going on. In terms of impact, well, there are consequences at different levels. Worker bees are essential, and without, the hive cannot sustain itself and will eventually die. Honeybees are responsible for pollination, and you can imagine how a colossal loss of bees can significantly impact agriculture. Certainly, CCD can have a huge economical impact, but also an ecological one. In fact, some bees have evolved symbiotic relationships with some plants. Without bees, the plants might die without reproducing. And if those plants are keystone species within an ecosystem, the entire ecosystem can collapse. I'm sad. Let's take care of bees. Do microscopic animals digest food? And if yes, how? Digestion is the process by which your body turns food into nutrients for energy and growth. And by food, I mean organic matter and not chemical compounds or light. When we think about digestion, we mainly think about the vertebrate digestion, starting with the mechanical digestion in your mouth, and then chemical processes where enzymes are going to break down the food into molecules that can be absorbed in the blood. Many invertebrates like insects, earthworms, or tardigrades use a similar way of digesting food. But if you keep zooming with your microscope, you will find organisms that don't have a digestive tract, like protozoa or bacteria. So how do they eat their own food? Many protozoa use phagocytosis, a process by which the food particle is engulfed within the cell and then digested by enzymes. Bacteria feed by extracellular digestion. They excrete enzymes that will break down the food particle outside the cell, and then the cell will absorb them. Hey guys, look, that's a Russian duck. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time for another quack. Whew!